Hi everyone, my name is Rachel and I'm a Global Product Lead on Google App Campaigns. If you're an advertiser running iOS app campaigns, you're probably familiar with the multiple measurement frameworks that exist, including Google's conversion modeling and Apple's SKAdNetwork, also known as SKAN. You can also check out our other video on understanding key measurement frameworks for iOS app campaigns to learn more about each. In this video particularly, I'll be deep diving on SKAN and how to set up your SKAN conversion value schema for better post-install measurement. We'll cover how SKAN conversion values work and best practices for configuring your schema for Google Ads. So let's get started. What is a SKAN conversion value schema? Your conversion value schema acts like a code, a series of numbers that designate discrete in-app actions or buckets of in-app revenue which matter to your business. Your schema is important to enable more comprehensive and accurate measurement for your in-app event performance and optimize your iOS campaigns for post-install actions or a target return on your ad spend. While Apple supports two versions of SKAN today, version 3 and 4, Google's conversion modeling only uses the fine conversion values from each for measurement and campaign optimization. We currently do not support version 4's coarse conversion values. However, we're assessing the potential for support in the future. Today's video will focus on the schema components specific to fine conversion values. There are some basic fundamentals you should understand when designing your schema. A fine conversion value in your SKAN schema refers to a numerical value of 0 to 63, which is sent to ad networks to represent specific user actions within a mobile app. This allows advertisers to measure campaign performance and optimize for valuable conversions, even with Apple's privacy restrictions. Data for these values can only be sent if the highest privacy threshold is met. By assigning fine conversion values to different in-app events, advertisers can gain more nuanced insights into user behavior and campaign performance. This allows for more effective optimization strategies within the privacy constraints of SKAN. Let's assess some best practices on how to configure your SKAN schema in a way that is valid for Google Ads. To start, you'll need to think about how you'd structure your conversion values based on what spectrum of events matter to your business. You can consider using a funnel approach, starting from the beginning of your user's journey and listing all the priority in-app events from upper to lower funnel. This entails listing out all possible conversion events and noting their conversion volume and rate. It's essential to choose high volume events when choosing which events to optimize your campaigns for. High volume events will help you avoid high null rates given the constraints of SKAN's shorter conversion window timers and privacy thresholds. Next, to successfully utilize the SKAN signals from your schema for campaign optimization, you'll want to ensure that your biddable conversion events are also represented in your schema design. For example, if in-app purchase or ad revenue is a priority for your business, you should also utilize some of your conversion values to indicate buckets of in-app revenue that may be relevant. Lastly, to ensure accurate SKAN measurement, align your campaign goals and SKAN conversion value setup. You should decide whether to count unique or all events and apply this consistently across both your campaign and SKAN event counters. This prevents discrepancies and allows for better optimization. After you've chosen your conversion values and events based on your business, you'll now need to determine where to set up your conversion value schema. If you aren't already working with a supported third-party app attribution partner on your SKAN schema strategy, you can also set up your schema through Google Analytics or the Google Ads API directly. Advertisers should only choose one place to set up their conversion value schema. We are also excited to share that you can integrate your SKAN schema events with your Google Ads account in order to enhance the performance of TCPA and TROS bidding in your iOS app campaigns. This SKAN event integration is available in beta. If you are using a supported third-party app attribution partner to set up your conversion value schema but bid to Google Analytics app events, please also know that we have launched a mapping feature in the Google Ads interface to support the mapping of event names between Google Analytics and app attribution partners. That was a lot of information, so let's recap. A well-designed schema is key for accurate post-install measurement and optimization. Consider using a funnel approach to identify your app's SKAN conversion values. You'll want to ensure your high-volume, biddable conversion events are represented in your schema. Lastly, determine one place to set up your schema. Thanks for joining. Be sure to check out our other videos for a walkthrough of an example schema design and how to evaluate your SKAN reports in Google Ads. You can also find more resources in the description below.